Hello, and welcome back to Age of Wonders 3. I am excited. I am very much looking forward to having a dwelling. It's going to be a bit of a tough fight. So, five healers and a massive tank. So, that'll be something. But... oh, did I... I was supposed to conquer that, wasn't I? We'll do that after. We'll clear this, and there's nothing else to clear down this. Well, okay, there's this area and this area which we really want to clear, but that's what the other heroes are for. Okay. Don't need to have our main squad do everything. Yeah, no, we're just gonna go for it. Actually no, let's be smarter about it and just move in with one unit. Probable victory. Yeah, you can see this is gonna be something harder. Oh, these things have throw curse, that's right. Hopefully they all fail. It's eating into my movement pretty bad. What's your resistance? Oh, your gold rank, okay. Okay. Just lost it. Oh, you got a lone archer over there. Well, that archer's toast. Okay, so this is, I believe, the first tier 4 unit that we're going to be interacting with in this game. Tier 4 are the highest tier, the strongest units in the game. And this one... well, it just hits really hard. It doesn't really do anything too special. It does have Guard Breaker, which means that if you're guarding, you still take reduced damage from its first attack, but then it breaks your guard status and the other two will go through normally. And additionally, you're no longer guarding, which means you can be flanked by other people afterwards. Okay, so taking out the archer. Who is going to do that? I don't really want to send one of my spiders to do it because... alright, they're also immune to blight. That's gonna hurt a little bit. Yeah, I don't really want to send one of my spiders to do it, but I guess I kind of have to. Oh, that's really unfortunate. Okay, well... Bro Filth is going to be pretty useless in this fight, honestly. How much damage do you do to this? You don't have a full set of actions left, so We're gonna hit you. Alright, fortunately, they've all used their... They've all used their actions up, so let's cast a rot. Or sorry, they all did an action, which means that they are not guarding. So the resistance is going to be lower. Yeah, it only hits four people, so we're hitting four casters. If we target this one, we could hit the Titan. Let's weaken the Titan as well. And the effect of weakened is... oh, you have negative morale now. That's really nice. Oh, and blight weakness, which is also nice. We can actually hurt you with that now. I can see you got quite a bit of movement. Now, these things have heal. They can only use this once per battle. So they're probably going to heal up. Three of them are going to spend their time healing. But that means... well... I guess we want you guys to come over this way. You don't have any movement left, because you've been attempted cursing too many times. So we'll move everybody else up this way. And yeah, you're probably going to throw a bunch of bolts at us, but that's fine. You two should be able to handle that without any trouble. Okay. Let's see what they do. Yeah, heal undead. Do they heal themselves? Yeah, monkey took a pretty bad hit there. Really unfortunate that the webbing failed. We've been having pretty good odds with the web. You have charge. You do not. I mean, you hit really, really hard, so... Yeah, weaken doesn't actually make you weaker in terms of your attack, unfortunately. Okay. Well... That's risky, we might die. I'd rather get the spider into the combat, but I guess... Take that out. No more archer. Yeah, so this archer... Just hide behind the pillar. The skeleton archer... I was thinking about this before starting the episode. The undead... Or sorry, the druid. Their bonuses are to archers, supports, and monsters. And that means that this archer... I don't know if I want to produce basic archers out of this town, but that is an option. Undead Slayer. Right, do you have projectile resistance? You do. It's unfortunate. Even with projectile resistance, your defense still isn't that great. Okay, well... Yeah. Oh, what am I doing? I should have cast another rot. How about you? If you cast Sphere of Protection, you could Sphere of Protection and then engage the Titan. That might be the best way. Who would engage? I mean, oof. Yeah, the Wolf Rider might be the better option, honestly. Alternatively, have you healed yet? You have not. Okay. If we do this, we'll definitely take you out. But then we might get a flank or a bunch of hits. This is a little bit dangerous. How much damage do you do? Pretty much none. It's just the Titan. Okay, well, we'll take you out. Good. Been denied a heal. And... Somebody might die. I think... You don't do fire, right? Yeah, you're gonna hit, it's gonna suck. But I think we've got the health. We're just gonna shield up like that. And make sure that we're not making our animals unhappy with the stinky poo from the monkeys there. Such a strange... Such a strange unit. I guess the Golden Realms expansion, which introduced the halflings, was had a more comical feel to it, and that the monkeys did come in that as well, so kind of makes sense. You already moved, you guys are done. Okay, we're just gonna move up like this, and we're just gonna wait and see what they do. Oh. Can you... I did not consider that. Are you going to be able to reach? Oh no, you're going... Okay, that's fine. Oh right, you get your throw curse back. That's good for me because you're staying out of range. Right, trying to curse the halberd here. Okay, well... You are the big target. I mean, that would make life a lot easier. But let's try it. No such luck. Okay. I mean, we do have Stunning Touch as well. Okay, there we go. Got it down. Then I guess we'll move up here. We're gonna cast another rot, which is gonna hit. Oh, you guys are actually pretty spread out. Interesting. I wonder if that was intentional. Okay, well, we probably don't need it at this point. the blight. Doesn't hurt me. Well, I would like to be engaging these, though. Okay, we'll just hit both of those. Light protection. Yeah, I think... we are going to... well, actually, we could... yeah. How much damage do you guys do? You do some? You're gonna have to move twice, right? In order to get me in range? That's pretty dangerous. I'm gonna sacrifice somebody, it should be the tiger, probably. You don't hit that hard. Okay, what we're actually gonna do is we're gonna defend with the tiger. And that way... yeah, you shouldn't be able to do that much damage. You're gonna be engaged. Alright, I would like the experience on this to go... with the spiders, if possible. Are you gonna level up after this? Maybe. To the spider or to my main heroes. It was 101 before, 103, yeah, okay, it's out of farming opportunity. So it's just gonna be the kill at this point. And the fumble. Alright, going for the hellhounds, so this is acting as a shield as well. Oh. Well, spider. Who are we going to give this experience to? Vampire spider baby? Yeah, 72. Yeah, 20. It's a good chunk. On the Titan. Okay, you can. Well, okay, you can move forward. You can run away. Moving so that we're not facing away from them. Alright. And we can't. Okay, well. We're gonna move everybody up. You are not going to fight this because you will take horrible amounts of damage, but... instead, you're going to guard, do the same trick again. We might actually... well, we're not going to kill you. We are one shot, not three, of course. Broken Spirit. Yeah, you're looking very weak at this point. Excellent. Defensive bonus, you get the fumble. Tiger got some good experience in that fight. Just fine. So yeah, this is... again, the power of the disables. Although I didn't really need it. If I didn't manage to disable the Titan, I would have still been able to take it out just by chain flanking it without taking too much damage. But yeah, that was fine overall. No casting points this turn, unfortunately. But yeah, we have ourselves... oh, a leader level up, that's right. Okay, sustainable warfare. expensive, but it halves the upkeep cost of everything in the party. It's pretty nice. Warm at night. Well, we're gonna go for sustainable warfare, and that means that basically we stack tier 3 and tier 4 units with our leader. That's the plan. So we have... this costs 8. We gain 5 per level, which means I can only spend 2. Or I can spend less than 5 and save up a point. So I think we'll be getting this in a couple of levels, because we're not producing high tier units just yet. So we're going to grab healing first. So we now have 2 heal abilities on this hero. Should help with recovery. And then normally I would grab the spirit protection, just to get those resistances. But I think we're gonna wait on that, and we get this in 2 more turns, so maybe... or in 2 more levels. Or it could be 3 more levels if we do natural immunity, warm at night, get the resistances for everybody. Light resist, hold resist, and then we'll get sustainable warfare around level 12, maybe? Of course, there's gonna be other stuff that's gonna unlock in the meantime that I'm gonna want. But that's the tentative plan. Okay, city awaits its fate. Well, okay, hasty plunder, we can get... actually not that much money. I was gonna say we get quite a bit for a dwelling, but that is in fact not the case. But no, we want to absorb this. Oh yeah, because we have that hasty plunder option, we can plunder in half the time. Release as a vassal? No. Absorb the city. In 4 turns, we will have ourselves a nice undead city. I do really want to clear this as well, because then we'll get the income from it. Like, we're getting no income until we absorb this, but picking up the tomb seems like it would be a good thing to do while we're here, and then this area, this city, is going to be completely under control. So let's just do that. This should be pretty easy. I'm going to send our big spiders in. I'm going to send in our leader, of course. We've got the stun, and who else? Everybody else is kind of injured. You would be a good option, but you're slow. I don't want to slow down my conquest in other areas. I guess we'll do the Wargrider and the Hellhound? Sure. Enter. What have we got in here? The Banshee, Reanimator, Caster, Reanimator, Reanimator, Hellhound. Nice, okay. And again, Chant of Unlife. Yep. Just clearing this so that we don't have to come back in the future. Ah, right, they could throw Curse. But the nice thing about that is it means that they're going to come for me. Alright, the Banshee's going to teleport and then do its Banshee's Wail and cause all kinds of problems. So what we're gonna do... Archon Caster. Do any of the reanimators do anything funky? The elf has total awareness, so it can't be flanked. Which is a thing. Frostling, I don't think you have anything special. Oh, inflict chilling, I was wrong. Of course you would. And human... Yeah, nothing out of the ordinary there, I would think. Do you not have Inflict Despair? Oh no, you have both. Wonderful. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna actually back up. Because... we want... Unfortunately, all of our heals are on this one character. As well as the Awakened Spirit. But yeah, we'll heal the Hellhound. Also, the, oh. Well, that was silly. Okay, you're gonna shield the Hellhound. You're gonna shield. And... you have a movement point left? You do. One of the goals of this is to charm the enemy's Hellhound. We're just gonna move everybody like that. You're gonna teleport here and possibly attack me, but we'll see. Oh, you're just gonna straight up attack. Okay. Everybody resisted. Beautiful. That whale you can't use for a couple of turns. Okay. Yeah, so our Hellhound should do a decent job against the reanimators. Need to web. I guess if we brought a monkey, we could better deal with it. Oh, you have, what is it? Spirit breaking. So that will make it a lot easier to mind control. Alright, reanimators. A little bit of trouble, because we don't have any range here. Yeah, you're highly resistant to everything. You're just going to be annoying. I guess this is our best option against you. Wait, that's a flank? Really? Huh. Don't mind if I do. Okay, yeah, that should take you out. And then... we're just going to run around and web everything, and at the very least... Alright. Even if it doesn't work, which it didn't, you're now in melee against something that you really don't want to be in melee against. So that's fun. I guess, again, we'll do it with you. Not having good luck with that today. Okay, we really... There we go. Yeah, we're gonna do this. And I think... we defend? Or do we attack? The problem with attacking is that then we open ourselves up to you. So we're actually gonna defend with both of these in order just to be engaged. And force them to take a step back and take a flank or something. I'm going for my leader, of course. Yeah, you're gonna do that, but then you're gonna... Oh, you're just gonna... Oh. Well, that was close. The problem with that, the strategy that I was doing, was that I wasn't draining their movement at all, which gave them more opportunities than I would have liked. Okay, well, you're done now, because if you run away, you're just gonna die. Take out this one. Good, oh, gold medal. What fun thing, oh, first strike, nice. That allows you to charge into pikes without suffering too badly for it. Okay, we really want to get this off, so let's... Archon caster. How do I want to do this? I guess we're going to ignore you for a turn. You're going to charge up here. Stunning touch. Nice. Plus one fire damage on the next level. Do that, you got to spare. So you're the only one with an action left. You are gonna heal yourself. And let's see, you two are stunned. You're the only living thing, so we don't have to worry about this. So let's just finish off the only thing that actually has an action, just to be safe. Okay. Next up, I really don't want to kill you, if I can help it. We're actually going to back off. Oh, no line of sight. Okay, come on, broken spirit. Resisted, that's unfortunate. Web, that's fine. You don't have... What are our odds here? 65, but it will be higher if we can land Broken Spirit, so I'm actually going to drag this out. In the meantime... Let's get some kills, get some experience around. Kill everything that isn't the Hellhound. Okay. We got 3 turns. Returns to try this. Oh. This is me getting greedy. way. Ah, okay. Darn criticals. Not what we wanted. A mana-powered heavy drill gives somebody tunneling. Hmm. Okay, well, we'll take the reward. I don't really want this. We could disenchant it. Who, if we were to give tunneling to somebody, who would we want them? Who would we want to have it? Probably our Bean Druid. It's fine. We'll just keep it. And then let's. Oh, you're out of movement. Alright, well, you three go here, because this is our squad. This is this squad. Alright. We don't have any. Well, we could do more terraforming, that's true. Since this is a money city. Flooding this as much as possible would be good. We only had two more tiles that we could do, fortunately. This city is very happy, but let's flood a little bit more. And not go too crazy on the mana. Okay, this fight, we're not completing that quest in time. So where are we going to explore from here? I guess we'll go down this way. Oh, right, we had this Blood Moon in effect. That's why stuff was doing so much physical damage in melee. I mean, the Titan's damage output was believable to me, so I didn't think about it at the time, but... Okay, well, you'll join... Yeah, look at that movement. Now that being said, we're not actually waiting around for you, but you'll catch up. You'll catch up soon enough. Let's just keep moving. Oh, that bear is so slow. We're just going to investigate. We're not actually going to clear this, more than likely. Yeah, oh yeah, that's pretty nasty. Fallen Angel, tier 4, Wraith King, which is support. So that was the other thing. The Archer was one option if I wanted to specifically leverage Druid abilities. But the Wraith King is probably what I'm going to go for, because we get the support bonuses. They'll be really, really fast with our upgrade. I think like 44 movement points or something like that, and they fly or float. So that'll be really good for us. So that's what we'll be doing with the Undead City. But yeah, no, there's no way we're dealing with that. Oh, that was dumb. Should have moved here. Doesn't. Oh, oops. Okay, well, apparently... What was it? What did I do? I hit F, and then it jumped to here. Okay, well, we want this one here. And, just keep moving, I guess. Yeah, the elephant and the bear are slowing us down. That's fine. So we've got all this to clear out. We're gonna go for this first. Oh no, that's off the map. It's just decorative. Okay. Clear that first. We can only attack that with 6. So if we're not using the bear... I mean, it's probably gonna be... Well, it's probably both the Blight Doctors, actually, because that thing has a nasty enchantment. Right, we've got you. Okay, well, a little bit late, but one thing that I was considering... Actually, I might want to give the drill to her. A little bit late in that we could have lowered your morale. We definitely want the halfling to have the mug of ale, because morale is especially important for halflings. So we'll just do that. And you are what? Well, we're not building machines there. I think you're going to sit in this city. And we'll get you some trebuchets eventually. That's the plan with you. And would have very much preferred a necromancer to lead my future wraiths, but it is what it is. Or even a theocrat might have been nice. More healing. Some anti-undead options. Alright, we have no spells. So let's just end the turn. If they were to attack us, I think this is the closest entrance. Oh no, this is so far south from where they are, actually. She'd be coming from up here somewhere. Whoa, really? Main invasion again. Ah, you guys. Okay, that's what it is. Founded. And look at that. This outpost already has 29 mana. Or 29 research. 23 from the Vault of Knowledge. 20 plus the 3 from our druid ability. And 48 gold. This is a fantastic city. We're going to get a builder's hall here, because we would like to be building stuff there. Gold is hard to upgrade. It's like the one thing you don't have a set of structures for in your city. But research, definitely we can stack research here. This is really going to help out. Hallock, we finally have an orc city. So what was the orc economic bonus? I can't remember offhand. It's not gold, mana, research, production, or growth. Every race has a specific thing. It's not morale, that's halfling. I believe probably it's Warhol is cheaper. Or is it barracks is cheaper? Might have been barracks is cheaper, at which point we kind of got nothing. One or the other. Anyway. Not the best. Let's build a spearman, just so that we can get some more defense, because there are some dangerous things in here. I'm surprised they haven't attacked us, honestly. You can discuss the alliance, become a vassal. Yes, we're gonna do that. Getting us some good points. We're still sort of evil. But that gets us more resources every turn, basically for free. You have a single wolf rider, and there's a pack of here that's probably just gonna come and kill you. Oh well, we'll conquer the city again if that happens. Research a tier 6 skill. Now, you are a sorcerer, so that does kind of make sense. If you want to beeline for that, you can just get through your tech thing, your main tech, unit techs, or casting techs. Those are fast ways to do that. So I wonder, Horned God is the final thing in our tech tree, so I wonder if they already have the Eldritch Horror. Is there their tier 4? Oh no, this is actually only tier 5, what am I saying? Okay, maybe not. Maybe it is casting points then that they did. Okay, our new spell was Vengeful Frost, if you want to, so from our water magic, let's do cold damage, a pretty cheap attack spell, with a different element, can be nice. 230 though, I don't really want Sunburst. But I want to be unlocking new things. I could also get Seafaring. Just unlock that so that we can embark. I haven't really felt a need for that, given that we're underground and that our hunters can swim. But if you research basic seafaring and advanced seafaring, the third and final upgrade in this tier is logistics, which makes your roads more effective. So you can move your armies around faster, which is pretty nice. Make archers and supports stronger. Yeah, maybe. Maybe we'll go with that. I'm not excited by these research options. I'm not going to waste time shuffling, though, because I want to get through everything eventually. Okay, you've grown. You're actually less happy now because you've grown into fewer... Well, part of the problem is you have so many rock tiles, which aren't good. If we were a dwarf, it would be better, but we're not a dwarf. You have grown. Yeah, and we don't have any money again. Well, 85 production. Okay, and this is something I believe this is the first time I could show this off. So we have a tier 2 treasure site here, Flow Rock Quarry. It unlocks the Flow Rock Citadel. So every one of the more advanced structures here unlock better, unique city improvements you wouldn't otherwise have access to. So in this case, the Flow Rock Citadel just means our produced machine units here get plus 10 health, which is a nice upgrade. And we don't have a siege workshop, but we will be getting that for the trebuchets as well, eventually. And also our walls heal every single round, which makes the city a lot harder to take out in a siege. We actually have enough money for this, so let's just get that going for now. Capital, just built a shaman, and honestly, we want that beetle command eventually. Maybe not in the capital, though. We have other stuff we could be doing. Okay, another settler. Where are you going? First of all, change. You're gonna get money for a turn. Okay, let's just finish all of these. This will give us access to the harbor here, which we're gonna want eventually. But for now, I guess we'll do housing. So if we grow once, then we gain access to the ancient ruins, the tier 1 research structure. Okay, we could grab that. We're gonna run around a little bit first. Oh, hello. See some halflings. Also, there's a cave entrance here. Oh, Eagle Rider. Okay, we don't know where this one goes. I would like to know. A little bit dangerous, though. Yeah, we're just gonna run away, explore some more. But there is a halfling city here, and a cave entrance. Good to know. Okay, continue. Well, this was a city site. But more importantly, I think we want to grow here. So we're going to start moving you this way, because this will be much faster, and then the spring will be cleared by the time we get in. This is a spring. Spring of Life allows you to get a Stables of Life, which gives you better cavalry. You might do the Beetle Command here eventually. Yeah, for now. You still cheerful? Yeah. Not in two turns, probably. It takes a lot of mana to terraform the entire planet. Who would have thought? Terraforming everything apparently is hard. Okay, so what have we got in here? Three apprentices, a wisp, and a baby shock serpent. As much as I'd like to charm that, I don't have a single serpent, do I? It's been a weird round for me. I got a bunch of spiders, but I also really like getting serpents because they also evolve, and they can evolve into a tier 4 eventually, instead of just the tier 3s like the spiders. Spiders are nice for the webbing, though, of course. Okay, so we're gonna go Hero, Blight Doctor, Hero, Blight Doctor, and what else? The two hunters, I guess. This isn't our strongest force, but we really don't want... Actually, have melee units in here, because enemy units, yeah, so we're gonna have shock weakness, and anytime we attack them in melee, there's a chance we'll be stunned. You know how much I like stun when I have it. Oh, I was dumb. I should have changed my research. Grabbed a cheap research before doing this. Man, let's play Curse, man. You're talking about stuff and you're not quite paying as much attention as you otherwise would be. Yeah, absolutely should have shifted over my spell in order to knock out one of those cheap researches. Because otherwise, those cheap researches are going to take me an entire turn to deal with. Okay, well, this is not ideal. Okay, well, we're gonna be able to... Oh, right, you have this. How silly. Problem here. This Frostling Apprentice is gonna hurt. Bleeding, okay. Take it out. Five. Four damage. So close. Okay, I guess... Fortunately, we do have to do this. How much damage are you gonna do? Not that much. Even if it's... Well, if it's doubled... This is doubled. You're doing... 8. 16, 24... to potentially 32. This could be really bad. And we might not even get a kill off of it. Okay, spell-wise, do we have options? Force field yourself. Flashbang. Flashbang might be the better option. Abort. I was just gonna shoot you. Berserk, not that likely. Okay, now this is really bad. Okay, well, what we're gonna do here? Okay, let's use the crossbow. Take you out. So that's one less hit we're taking. Problem is, you're going to attack this, you're possibly going to be stunned, you can phase, attack, flank, yeah, I'm... This is just so bad. No, what we're going to do is we're going to retreat, and then we're going to flashbang 65. Okay, good. On the hero. Oh no, that was surprising. But yeah, we were just being a little bit too aggressive there. I had to back it up. Move here. Not the best option, but good enough. Level up on the Blight Doctor. What was the second one? Yeah, Veteran. Oh, much as you just hit, you got Steel Enchantment. Cool. Okay, we're gonna try this now. Okay, success. Range penalty, it's not. Let's use our Animal Slayer. Courtesy of the Adventurer's Slingshot. And we can just finish you off with whoever. I'd rather give the experience to the Doctor than the Hunter. Although, you would have hit Final Rank, which would have been nice. But it's not that big a deal. And, yeah, 107 research. Just basically squandered because it's not even going to give us a turn off of this. We now need 243. So what I'm going to do to make up for my mistake is I'm not going to research this now. I'm going to wait until I get 13 more research, and then we'll one-turn this, because the research will be saved. The progress will be saved. So, Domain of Corruption? I mean, I don't really like any of these. I'm not going to cast... The thing is, I'm not going to use any of these, except for maybe Storm Magic would be nice to have. Favorite enemy is just a passive that's useful. This is so expensive. So we'll take Druidry. We'll just get more casting points. Okay, up to the dwarf town. And yeah, I put you both with one butcher deliberately just so that your movement points would be the same. We got another library up here. More cities. I guess I really don't need to be using both of you for this, probably. There's nothing in this area that looks like it would require a full 12 people. So actually, I might send you this way and just deal with this. That might be the more sensible thing to do. Okay, right, we have you guys. This is the Warlord's stack, I believe, and... Wait a minute. No, wait, what are your abilities? No, I've got it reversed. Whoops. You go in the archer stack. You go with the melee here. Okay, just move forward. I think I was right. Doesn't really matter. It'll be right now. Okay, well, we're gonna send you up to our new our orc city. Summon wild animal. Yeah, let's just get some more defense here. Another monkey. Thing is, we want our druid here. Yeah, we really should be splitting up these armies, though. So maybe the druid will come this way, and the sorcerer will go the other way. Okay, another divine invasion. Very, very nervous about this. Item has arrived. Inventory. Yep. Your morale is now... Yeah, you don't like being underground, but... Well, you have some other bonuses, so you're kind of okay. You can just sit there for now. Our egg hatched. Yes, you now have a raptor. Inflict bleeding wounds and 40% fire protection. Which, with your forge aprons, puts you up pretty high. Can you take fire resistance? If you have a 20% fire resist, that would actually be pretty funny. We could get you immune to fire. But yeah, you even look different now. Get yourself a nice raptor. It's okay. It's probably one of the weakest mount items in the game. But, not too bad. Should have grabbed Vengeful Frost with that. Oh well. Or Seafaring. Okay, we'll take Sunburst just to get it out of the spellbook. Okay, we got a quest available. What is it? Slay the dragons. Oh, but it looks like Wyvern is the strongest of them. Or Wyvern? Wyvern? I've never been sure how to pronounce that word. Alright, but we got a Buttercup Fairy for it. That wouldn't be bad. And if we're heading out in this area anyway... I mean, more free troops are pretty good. Buttercup fairies are not the most intimidating things, if the name wasn't a giveaway on that. Okay, we've got some... Got some people here. What does this town want to do? Ultimately, what did I want to do with this town? What was my plan? Well, it was to expand out to this and then use that. Right. Expand out to this and then use it to build units. So I guess the War Hall is ultimately what we want here. But yeah, we get orc, shamans, and hunters here instead. I guess. Your production is not that great. Honestly, but we don't have a lot of money, and I don't do housing. I don't care too much about what you're doing at the moment. Okay, good. Another settler. So you're going down that way. So you will go up this way. And I mean, there's a couple of places we could settle. Actually, I think you were going to go here, weren't you? Is that more melons? We just ran over the haste berries. Sure. And we'll be lucky for what that's worth. Oh yeah, still haven't grabbed the chest. I guess the polar bear could be doing that. Hey, well, we can afford the beetle command. Tier 2 druid structure. I think actually we are having some mana issues now. So let's get that going. Yeah, we're gonna start upping our mana. You guys have a temple? You do, because you've been producing things with it. Okay, well, in your case then, how about an observatory? A great temple. Well, we can't afford it. An observatory. You just get to build housing, because we don't have a lot else to do with you. Let's explore down this way. Oh, this node's been cleared. Ah, more halflings. Lovely. Where we're hiding. What is this? Oh, this is a dwelling. So we're at war with them. They have a merfolk dwelling, which got an oyster reef. Pretty nice. Yeah, definitely like to take that. Although the Lord of the Deep, another tier 4 unit in there. Some nasty stuff there. Okay, change of plan. You guys are going this way. Ah! You kill me. Okay, well, anyway, we'll, send you out this way. You are responsible for subjugating these dwarves on your own. I think you'll be able to manage. Oh, there are animals here too. Oh, but these are good animals. We don't want those. So yeah, we'll just kill them. That's fine. Here. Oh, we're running up this way. Still got some movement left. Clear, clear, clear. Should be fine. Ooh, there's a goblin shaman here. And some more animals. Druid can't be everywhere. Although we have a shaman now, right? Yeah, we do have our own shaman. And you have befriend animal, so we can try. We can try at least. But that's going to be it for now. We've got ourselves the biggest thing. I mean, we settled a bunch of cities, which is really cool. It's going to help us out in the long term. Also in 2 more turns, so probably in the next episode, we'll be able to explore the Archon build tree, which I'm quite excited about. And like I said, I'm probably building towards Wraiths is the plan. Yeah, so we'll investigate that in the next part. I will see you then.